Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the BGP weight attribute. Now, Border Gateway Protocol, or BGP, is a path vector routing protocol that's used on the internet, as well as on large enterprise networks. When BGP has two or more possible paths to a particular destination, it examines a series of attributes of each of those paths to determine which is better, and thus which should be placed into the routing table. Now, these attributes are examined in a standardized and predefined sequence. Every time there is a tie, it goes on to examine the next attribute until an attribute is found for which one path is better than the other. If you want to see an overview of this process, take a look at my video about BGP attributes and determining the next path. The link is in the description below. Now, the very first attribute that this process examines is the weight attribute. Now, this is an interesting one because this is actually a Cisco proprietary attribute. It's not part of the official definition of BGP. However, because of Cisco's influence on the development of the internet, this attribute has become widely used by other vendors as well. The weight attribute is local to the router on which it's configured. This means that it doesn't get advertised or shared between BGP peers. Now, the weight is a 32-bit value, and that value is set to 0 for all routes that the router learns from its peers. For routes that the router originates itself, for example, local routes, static routes, routes that have been redistributed into BGP on the local router, the default weight is set to 32,768. Now, in the BGP best path selection process, it is a path with a higher weight that's preferred over a path with a lower weight. Now that we've seen some of the characteristics of the weight attribute, let's take a look at this attribute in action. We're assuming that we're using Cisco routers, so all of the commands and outputs that you will see are those that you would see in a Cisco router. Now, let's take a look at this particular topology. We have a BGP router within AS100 that learns about multiple paths to the 30.30.30.0 destination network. If we don't change any default values of BGP throughout the topology, it is the AS path attribute that will kick in, preferring the green path over the red path. This is because the green path traverses fewer ASs than the red path. Let's say, however, that we want to make sure that the red path is taken. Let's use the weight attribute in our BGP router to achieve this. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to change the weight of the path learned from the R2 router over the path learned from the R1 router. I've labeled these routers and I've also given them IP addresses, which will be used as the next hop addresses. Now, let's take a look and see what the BGP table looks like in our BGP router. Notice that the BGP router sees two paths, one via R1 and one via R2. And we can see this by the IP addresses of the next hop. But it has chosen R1 as the preferred path. This is due to the fact that the path is shorter, and it's using that AS path attribute as the tiebreaker in this case. Notice as well that the value of the weight applied to each of those is 0. Remember, 0 is the default value assigned to paths learned from other sources. Now, let's use the weight attribute to influence the choice of the best path so that the red path is chosen over the green path. Now, with these commands, we enter into the BGP configuration and we set the weight of the neighbor 2.2.2.2 to 500. This command essentially tells the local BGP router that any routes learned from the 2.2.2.2 neighbor, which is R2, should be assigned a weight of 500. Then we issue the clear IP BGP star command, which essentially clears and reestablishes the BGP peerings. Now let's take a look and see what changes we see in the BGP table of our router. Notice that the greater than sign here, which indicates the best path, has changed. We now have a next hop of 2.2.2.2, which is our R2 router. Notice also that we have a weight of 500 for this particular path. So BGP, based on this first weight attribute, has chosen the path via R2 as the best path. So the immediate effect of the weight attribute in this scenario is on the selection of the next hop. We chose R2 over R1. But by setting the next hop to R2, the broader consequence is that we're choosing not just the next hop, but the entire path that has been advertised by R2 over that of R1. Now, in our example here, we applied the weight value to all routes learned from R2 using the neighbor command. So if R2 informs our BGP router about 10 different routes, all those routes will have a weight of 500. But what if we want to be more granular in our configuration? And what if we want to assign a weight of 500 only to the 30.30.30.0/24 network and not to other routes learned via R2? How do we do that? Well, we can actually do that by applying what's called a route map to our neighbor peering in the BGP configuration. We won't show how it's done here, but suffice it to say that it is possible to assign a specific weight value to specific routes and not just to all routes learned from particular neighbors. Now, the weight attribute is commonly used in scenarios where there's a need to influence outbound routing decisions on a router. It's convenient because it's easy to apply, and it's relatively safe because it remains local to the router, so it doesn't actually impact the routing decisions on other BGP routers in the network. So the weight attribute is the first BGP attribute that's checked. If the weight is the same, then it goes on to check subsequent attributes until a tiebreaker is found. As always, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click the thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other topics related to BGP, please feel free to let me know in the comments, and subscribe to get updates to our newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at telecomTech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.